I think this one's $2 million. $2 million. $5 billion Colombian dollars.
Oh wow, I like that house. It's like got like a modern feel, but also like a throwback vibe.
It's in Guatemala City, and it's in a neighborhood, and it has a nice little backyard.
Nothing special, but still costs a lot. Expensive country to live in.
Historic home, next to Old San Juan.
It sounds like an episode of House Hunters International, but it's actually a way to engage Spanish 3 students at Jackson High School in Massillon.
We have our Spanish families, and we look for houses to buy because our families are moving to Hispanic countries.
Therese collaborates with her Spanish 3 family as they research online for the right casa or house. Once they find it, each member of the family writes about an aspect of the home. After their writing gets the thumbs up from Señor Fraudel, it will become part of a family website that covers various life experiences.
So if you click, for example, if we go to period 6 and we go to Zima Zima de Villa as an example, and this is what they do. So they research, they will actually write their composition, their paragraphs. It says, nosotros no pagamos mucho para la casa, pero pagamos todo el dinero que nosotros tenemos. So we didn't pay a lot for this house, so we used the money that we have, because they don't have a lot of money. Because actually this family, they work in a circus, so they are like clowns and things like that, so they don't have a lot of money.
So clowns don't make a lot of money?
They don't, according to them.
El barrio is rico, porque las casas son muy grandes. LeBron James, Donald Glover, Mark Cuban, even in El barrio.
Not every family is made up of struggling circus performers. Many choose to be muy rico, affording a home with rich and famous neighbors. During oral presentations, the students learn from each other, with the family websites projected in front of the class.
Since this is a Spanish class, we don't want to spend too much time teaching these guys like how to create web pages. So we want to use something that is really easy for them. Type and paste or whatever they want and then post it online. So what we do is we use a website called Weebly. Weebly is very nice. You just go and you have to create an account, and then they have different like formats you can choose from.
This is definitely not your parents' Spanish class. Among the various technology used in class, there is one notable old school element missing, a textbook.
We don't have a book, but what we do is we have everything online and for the students. We have the vocab, we have quizzes, we have grammar, we have everything in for them.
In addition to finding all the content they need online, the students have various technological tools to help their learning. One favorite is Quizlet, which is like audible flashcards.
They can click off a word and then
Adoptado.
It pronounces for them. So for the students that have problems with pronunciation, they can actually practice at home. So comía means I should eat. So then you put check answer, and then it tells you if you are wrong or if you are okay.
If I have in my mind that I'm doing something right and it turns out that I'm doing it wrong, I won't be able to like correctly fix that unless I know that I'm doing it wrong. So it's helpful that like I have something to guide me.
And once you have the code with your phone, then they will start posting questions. And here you will see the names of the students. So you can see the progress, and you can see how they answer, and you can see at the end the most common mistakes.
Abria?
It's Abria, not Abria.
I'm answering homework questions for the conditional tense.
After using their virtual Spanish program for a while, the Jackson High School Spanish teachers decided to test themselves. So for a couple of years, they went back to the textbook.
Number one, I mean, the students don't learn as fast as before. And also we were losing some students because when they sign up to go like for upper level, like Spanish 4, for example, our numbers were down a little bit. But if you compare like the previous years, the numbers were way higher. So when we switch back to virtual Spanish and our numbers are up again. So the students really love this type of learning.